Good morning, friends.
Good morning.
Once again, loud good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, wish you warm welcome to our YouTube channel. And in case you do not subscribe, you can subscribe our YouTube channel to receive the regular updates about the new video. And today we are in day 3 of batch 4 be a HNI NRI portfolio planner to the investor family. And we have 4 participants, and our 4th participant is one of the youngest participant. His name is Shrey Tanna. He has successfully completed his CFP certification in March 2019, at age of 19. So congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, and I'm very happy that normally in a young age or teenage, he started his journey at age of 17. Normally many of time people at age of 17 Mumbai, because your junior college start 11th example. Ideally, or maybe you are in a second year, or you may move into the from junior college to even your senior college in Mumbai. Okay, and people are in a mood of enjoyment. Yes, now college days started. So his parent took a very unique decision. Okay, instead of going into the traditional college format, he opted for the distance learning. And he has pursued his commerce BCom in distance learning mode. So right now he is into third year. He successfully completed his CFP. 6 months he was in Mumbai with me in training. Then another 1 year he was in at hometown in Gujarat, Damnagar. Okay. After CFP, he decided to go for the CFA level 1. Again, at young age 19, he come back to Mumbai, and I said this time you need 80% of your time investment in next 3 years in Mumbai, and you will go for examination only in Mumbai. Okay. So this is a very unique and good example for the any teenage parents. Okay, or maybe a teenage, or maybe a fresher in age of 21 looking for a quality career in finance. So what Shrey, I expect from you. Okay, already I have shared your detailed introduction, so you can start with that specifically, what you learned in last 2 full days and how you will help your parents, because your parents are also HNI category parents, or your family belongs to HNI category. So how you help your family to be a better investors?
Good morning.
Very good morning.
Myself Shrey, I have completed my CFP in this March 2019, and currently I am pursuing my CFA level 1 with Keyur sir, and I am also working as a trainee financial planner with Keyur sir, and also working as a co-mentor helping the CFP aspirants to reach at the level of CFP practitioners. In last 2 days of portfolio planning workshop, I have learned that there are principles that in CFP we have learned the financial planning process, means we have to create goal-based planning, includes of goals such as retirement, education, vacation goals, need-based and some want-based goals. But there are such families who have such corpuses that their goal will be achieved from that corpus, but they also have some surpluses. So how to plan such surpluses is to be get learned from portfolio planning, which is a part of CFA curriculum. So basics of portfolio planning is that first of all you have to create some IPS types, means the investment policy statements, means we have to learn that what are the client's requirements, requirements in the sense of time horizon we can say, after the liquidity, which are their emergencies requirements in few years, means we can say in 3 to 5 years. After, we have to also look through the some taxation parts and also some of the legal parts of that. And after creating such portfolio plan, we have to go to the product selection. Yesterday in full day we have learned the product selection of equity as well as debt. In equity I can say there is a sector named BFSI, banking and financial sector, which has been outperformed in last few years, means we can say in 10 years. So apart from that, all mutual funds are also investing their stakes of 20 to 30% in BFSI,
30 to 40%
in BFSI, such as FT, we can say HDFC, ICICI. If we will choose any fund of large caps, there will be a 30 to 40% exposure of BFSI. The main thing I have learned is that The Sensex and Nifty are also based on market capitalization. Mm. We have to create an equal weightage portfolio. Mm. Means I cannot say no to BFSI, but there should be an exposure maximum to 10 to 15% we can say to BFSI. And there are some other sectors like automobiles, we can say, which have not performed in past years. So we have to put the exposures in that also. Mm. That we learn from the principle of convergence. Mm. Means how the future potential will be worked of the particular companies and also particular sectors. Mm. So we also have to learn the top-down approaches. Means we have to go through the economy, then we have to go through the sectors, which sectors have not performed in past years, but they have generated good profits from there. Mm. But the share price, due to some technical reasons, have not performed. Mm. So we have to choose such kinds of equity portfolios. Mm. And going through the debt, I have learned that debt can be more riskier in recessions. Mm. Means like we have seen the DHFL crisis and all that. They get defaulted and they are not paying the credit as well as the principal amount back to the client. So that NAV will get full, the particular mutual fund who have invested in that. So in the selection of debt fund, you also require expertise. How the time horizon of the debt funds, what will be the YTM, what are the selections of debt which are been selected by underlying instrument which are selected by the fund managers. So if client is ready to take the credit risk, then we can provide him such kind of debt funds. But if client is coming from FD to invest in debt funds, then we have to give such kind of liquid funds and which have more exposure to T-bills and commercial deposits, CD. Mm. So
bank FD.
Bank FDs. Mm. So this was my key learnings in last 2 days.
Very good. Excellent.
So now, as I said, you belong to HNI family, okay? And you have completed CFP, now you are moving towards CFA journey, okay? And part of CFA journey, you are attending the portfolio planning approach. So how you are going to help your family?
As of I have seen my family's portfolio, we have reviewed before 3-4 days. I can say there is a more exposure into mid caps and small caps, means there is high risk in portfolio, I can say. So I will suggest my uncle that in part of debt, we have high exposures in liquids as well as some long-term debts. So I will also suggest to go in some part of into the PPFs, means public provident funds, which gives tax-free returns in long terms as well as after 5 years you can withdraw 50% of the amount. So I would suggest in long-term debts, it's better and advisable to invest in PPF, which is EEE, exempt from investment, exempt from growth and exempt from withdrawals. So this was my key learning, and I will suggest my parents to do such the same.
Good. So is it not necessary when I have to suggest one HNI, I talk about the only debt mutual fund. Suppose I have given an allocation of 20% debt, fixed income. So as a part of, I can say if there are 5 adult members is there, so ideally you must have a 5 PPF account for each adult member, and you put it to 1.5 lakh rupees. So what happened that key, where people may misguide you that key, it is a 15 year locking product. No, it is a 5 year locking product, and after 5 year you have a option to withdraw whichever is lower, 50% of the immediate preceding year or 50% of the fourth preceding year. So indirectly you can withdraw at least after 5 year your first installment minimum 1.5 lakh rupees. Okay, and then it will be increasing. So what happened that advantage is that PPF will give you a cushion of risk-free, tax-free and good return. Right now it is a 7.9%, and client also find happiness. Na? Yes, someone who is suggesting which no one has talked about, and you can say that I am not going to earn single rupee out of this. Okay, even though I am suggesting to you, because this is suitable as a part of the debt asset allocation. Okay. So I suggested Shrey, you have a 6-7 adult member, and as a part of debt asset allocation you must have, okay. And as well as when there is a one HNI family has a, let's say example, 10 member and 4-5 members are working, okay. Family and have a 4-5 earning member, okay. an active age, okay, so their objective is not to generate the high return on portfolio, but their objective is to first avoid the capital loss. As I said yesterday, when you avoid the capital loss in a long term, you have won half the battle, and same time your objective is to preserve the capital as well as the generate the 2-3% inflation adjusted tax adjusted return. And second, when you are earning the income, so you can add into your surplus. Third, even you can avoid some kind of investment mistakes, okay, or you can reduce your some lifestyle expenses, which also help you to generate the more surplus. So what is always better for anyone is to reduce the lifestyle expenses, which can give you more surplus on an immediate basis, as well as to earn more income, okay, or avoid some kind of investment. So when we do a bundle of this thing, then return will be a very secondary. Okay, anything you would like to share right now, conclude anything? So I thank you very much. I thank you very much, Shrey, to share his learning in a very crystal clear manner, or you can say very crisp manner. And I am sure that for Shrey, your biggest HNI customer is your family. So you have to make sure that after 1 year, you will be able to influence them and make it into some kind of a correct or better way. Tomorrow someone will say that in your journey of CFA level 1 or level 2, or when you completed CFA all three level, what did you do apart from passing the exam? Honestly speaking, 9 out of 10 people fresher do not have an answer. Okay, apart from passing the three level exam, even in CFP, that's the reason we are different, na? Okay, we are more focused on a practical application, and charity begins from the home. So even your parents educated with your knowledge and skill set, definitely later on they can also basically help you to get it to some other relatives, na? Okay, yes, way my son has helped me, so aap uski help lete hai. Jab aapke parents koi aapke relatives ko unke friend ko recommend karenge, yahan pe paisa earn karna important nahi hai. Hamare liye kya important hai, ek education dena. Definitely kahin pe meri help chahiye hogi to definitely they have to pay the money. Okay, so I thank you very much, Shrey, for sharing his valuable insight. Thank you very much.